We must start connecting systemic racism, most seen through systemic voter suppression and gerrymandering, poverty, the lack of health care, environmental devastation, and the war economy. Let me make the connection. In our state, we just found out the other day that our legislators, while I was being convicted, it came out that they actually lied to a federal court. They lied to a federal court about their racist redistricting plans, said they could not fix them because the state had already ruled one court that our legislature is unconstitutionally constituted because of racist voter gerrymandering. So they're in office not because they won, but because they cheated. More people voted for progressives, but because of racist gerrymandering, they're in office. Now what they do is they use the power that they've obtained through racist gerrymandering to deny health care to 500,000 people, to deny living wages, to attack women, to attack the gay community. So it's connected. They would not have the power to do what they're doing without racist voter suppression and racist gerrymandering. And in reality now, people are saying they were the real trespassers, because they lied to a federal court, because they used racist voter gerrymandering to get in office. And one judge has already said it was surgical racism. Actually, the Fourth Circuit said that. It was surgical racism. And another judge has said it was their unconstitutionally constituted body that has been passing policies that's hurting all people, especially poor and low wealth, black, white, brown, Asian, and Latino people. We have to understand the connections, Amy, and that's why we can no longer fight in our silos. We have to fight together.